All right, guys, so we are back this week for another weekly grind video. If you are new here, this is the video I just go over all of the events on both the JP and the global side of Dokkan Battle in terms of events and summonings, which ones are currently up and when they end. So let's go ahead and just jump right into it. First one we're going to talk about, Defeat the Legendary Super Saiyan. This event is currently available. Go ahead, grind it out until Monday, 11/13. So this is the one that get the longest availability for, so at the 13th, and that is what date? We have about 2 weeks about 2 weeks, I'd say, because what, today's the 25th November. My stupid calendar here, let me bring this over here so you can actually see what I'm looking at. That won't work. 25th, then we got the first is 1 week, and then two, so I actually got about 2.5 weeks for this before it goes away, or 3 weeks before this goes away. So there's enough time to grind that out. This is for a whole bunch of different things. You can grind out Videls, you can grind out Trunks. I actually should go out and grind out some Videls, just so that way I could use, because I never finished grinding her to Super Tech 10. I think she's only at Super Tech 5 on my account. And the base form Trunks, he's not really that great at all. Leader ability kind of sucks too. So, I mean, he is an SR, what do you expect? This is how you get medals to Dokkan Waken, the Super Saiyan Goku, this guy right here, the Gohan and the Goten. These are the ones who are the Broly killers for the two Broly events. For the one Broly event that has three different stages. But for the two stages, you actually need to worry about them. Anyway, that is that. And then you also get the Shamu guy. Shamu, is that his name? All enemies attack and defense minus 30% for two turns. So that's not that bad at all. He's really useful, so you can go ahead and grind him out as well. Again, he's only here, he's here for about another 2.5 weeks, so you have time to grind him out. The next one is the new Bio Broly event. That's going to be here till the 8th of November, so you guys have definitely enough time to grind that out. Good luck on that grind. I don't know if you're going to be going for him. You get the Krillin, you get the Bio Broly. Bio Broly isn't really worth it too much. He's a good defender, so you can use him against the LR Freezer or the LR Goku event. That's the only time I could see him being viable, just because the tech team is the best one to bring up against both of those events. So take it for what you will. If you already have an OP team and you don't need another defender, because I'll tell you right now, the team that I have without Bio Broly does just fine, and I don't barely use any items, so you don't need him. He might just come in handy for a replacement of like Jackie Chun or something like that, because Jackie Chun's not on primary rotation, and since they're all free to play, you should be doing the optimal rotations. Anyway, you also get the Awakening Medals for Android 18, the new one that's available, and the OGs, Super Saiyan Goten and Super Saiyan Trunks. So go ahead and grab them while you can. This Trunks is really worth it. I already did a full video on that, so if you haven't checked it out, go ahead, check it out. This is really worth it. And I think you could grind out a whole bunch of Hercule statues, so you can go ahead and just do it on Z-Heart. But the thing is, they don't give you guaranteed gold, so that kind of sucks. But anyway, yeah, you have some time to grind that out, but I would recommend at least going for the medals to Dokkan Waken these three guys, because these are not Dokkan exclusives. Alright, the next one is going to be the Go Forth Hero of Justice Begins. That's going to end on November 5th, so you have a little bit of time left for that. You have about, a week and a half left for that? About a week and a half left, so go grind that out. This is, you get the Gohan, he Dokkan Awakens into Great Saiyan Man. The Great Saiyan Man is actually, I think this, the Strength one, I think he's the one who greatly lowers attack. Correct me if I'm wrong, but then you also have the Agility one who Dokkan Awakens, so that's awesome. Let's see, he doesn't actually say here, either way, and then you also get the medals to Dokkan Awaken, my girl over here, Videl. Both of these girls Dokkan Awaken into Great Saiyan Man 2, so both of them are both meh, but whatever, what can you do? That's what you should do with them, to Dokkan Awaken them if you want to. I believe these two also do well, one or the other, you choose, do well against the Broly event as well. It's probably why they're out, because it's all Broly oriented right now. I'm pretty sure. Was it Broly? I think it's Broly that these two go up against that do really well. Or is it Kid Buu? Either way, I think it might be the Kid Buu event then. Regardless, you could go ahead and Dokkan Awaken them if you want. None of these guys are really relevant unless you're going up a specific event. It should have to do with the Majin Buu event, with the two of them linking together for their special link skills. Correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments below. I just completely forgot what those tokens are meant for. 10 Billion Power Warriors are still here till 10/31. Thankfully, these will be off my next, this mission will be off my next weekly grind video. Oh, thank God. There is nothing here at all worth the grind. There's nothing here. None of these guys are worth it. These medals, nothing. Nothing here is worth it. Don't worry about this event. Only grind it out if you have nothing else to do or for the medals. I mean, for the Dragon Stones. Get the Dragon Stones. That's it. Anyway, next one. Pan Secret Adventure daily until 10/31. Guys, please make sure you grind this out for experience. 200,000 per 80 stamina. Grind it out once a day. It's definitely worth it. If you're not there, grinded all the lower ones. I mean, I have never grinded out the two lower levels just because when it came out, I was already had enough. I was at like high enough rank for me to actually utilize the 80 stem. So go ahead and jump into that while you can. I actually, just because this is out every single day, I decided to do the other two so I can get the two dragon stones from it that have just been hanging there. But yeah, go ahead daily. Make sure you do it. I already leveled up a couple times, and I'm over 400, level 400, so it's very hard for you to start ranking up once you're over like 380. That's when things really started slowing down for me. At least I noticed it. Next one, Warrior from the Other World arrives. The Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku event. This is where you grind out the medals. Same thing with the Mass Saiyan. Both of these end on 1101. So you have another about a week for that for you guys to grind that. Actually, exactly a week for you to grind that out. Both of these for those medals. Honestly, I have all the Bardocks. I have all the Gokus except for the two banners. So it's a pain in the butt because each of them have three separate Dokkan Awakenings, which is 35 medals apiece, and it's a pain in the butt. Plus, you need the 77 medals for the primary units, so there's a lot of grinding to do. So honestly, if you can do it, go through all of them. I haven't been renewing my stones just because the primary Bardock that I use is a strength one, so I Dokkan Awakened him, and I'm holding off on the tech one just because I only need one more dupe path to unlock of him before he's 100%. Well, before I have enough to open up that dupe path. If I get one more of him for that dupe path, then I'm just going to throw on some defensive stats onto him, so that way I can give him a little bit more of a buff. But yeah, he's pretty badass right now. I can't wait to showcase him once he's like, I don't know if I'm going to 100% him, but I'm definitely going to showcase him for what he's at. I think he's at like 70%. Then we're going to talk about the summons right now on the global side. Summons for the Bio Broly event. The Bio Broly summons is 1108. That's when it ends, so you have about 2 weeks left for that. I will say this banner isn't really worth it, but for 30 Dragon Stones, if you're not free to play, or if you have an abundance of stones, or if you're not like saving for a specific banner, you're just here to play, the sale's really good. 30 stones for a multi-summon, and it has all three LRs. You do have a chance, whether it's a very slight chance. I know I said it in my video that I did the summoning in, and I ended up pulling an LR, but that is not something that happens often. They have each LR has a 0.045% pull rate. That's because all three of them are there. When you add all that up, 0.045 times, three, it comes out to what, like almost 1.0, just under one, but it's about 1.4%. So you have 1.4% to pull one of the three LRs, just adding them all together. I wouldn't recommend it, guys. If you're saving for a specific banner, don't do this. Maybe if you want to pop off one multi just to get the itch out of the way because it's only 30 stones, you never know. Both these guys are really good. I will be doing a little team building between the three of these just because it was a request. So that's going to be a little bit of probably about a 20-minute video because I'm going to go over all three of them. But yeah, outside of that, not really sure if you guys want to actually pull on this or not, but they are not bad cards at all. Then they also have the old school Goten and Trunks, so both of these are worth it. This Trunks is really good on a mono physical team. He's actually a primary unit on that physical team, so if you don't have him, that might be another consideration for you if you're trying to go for a mono physical team. Anyway, I think he's also going to be on the, he should be on the Super Saiyan 3 banner, I believe, the Gotenks. I'm not sure, don't hold me to that. I'll be doing a review of it when it becomes available, because they change that stuff up all the time. Dokkan Fest starts now. Also, one more thing on the global side is going to be the Bardock and Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku. They are on the same banner. But remember, the Bardock is not a Dokkan exclusive, so he will show up in other banners. So you can get him in the future. So you don't have to get him now. If you don't have him now, don't worry about it. It's not gonna, like, he only comes out once a month on a specific banner. He can be on multiple banners, and he's going to have that really zero, that low chance on multiple banners as well if he's not a featured unit. Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku is the one you really want to go for. But if you haven't gone for him yet, probably hold off. I can't give you a guarantee, but the chances are he's going to be on the Super Saiyan Gogeta banner. Global does things a little bit funky. I can definitely see them putting the Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta banner card on the Gogeta banner, the like Super Saiyan Gogeta banner. If they do that, they might take Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku off. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see, and wait and find out to see what they're doing. Or they could just do like quadruple Dokkan Fest, who knows. The next one is going to be the last one, is the World Tournament Summons, which I still haven't done yet. I'm going to go through all my silver tickets with you guys, and I'm saving the gold tickets for something else, because I know that Bandai is going to do something special for the World Tournament at some point. It's not like I have like a connection or anything like that. It's just from what they've done in the past and how boring the World Tournament's gotten and how much flack the World Tournament's getting, even though we have a lot of participants, they just go for the mission rewards. And I feel like they're going to do something special for guaranteed SSRs instead of just giving previous cards in there. I do want to go for that Bardock. I really want that Bardock for my mono team and that Turles, because I don't have that Turles. But outside of that, meh. There's no real reason for me to use all my gold tickets on it yet. Anyway, that's available till the 26th, so that ends tomorrow, guys. So if you haven't used your tickets in the World Tournament, go ahead and use them. All right, now we're jumping over to the JP side of Dokkan Battle. Oh, I'm sorry. This is one more thing left on the global side. My bad. Strength banner ends tonight. So if you want to go for that banner, go for it. This is the LR Broly's on here. I wouldn't recommend going for him here, specifically because he usually gets his own exclusive banner. Whether it's going to come up again in the future or not, I think it's come up twice on the global side so far. So if it comes up again, I don't know when it's going to come up. It would probably come up before the next World Tournament. So if you're doing it specifically for LR Broly, I would recommend against it just because he has his own featured banner. But if you're going for the Elder Kai's, then it might be worth it for you, or if you want any of these great strength units, especially that Super Saiyan 3 Kid Goku, the one from GT, the one that transforms into Great Ape. When you Dokkan Awaken him, if you have Super Saiyan 4 Goku, he does link very well. He's his best linking buddy. I think they pop off each of all the links of each other. So I would recommend going for it if you don't have that card. Plus, they all come in at max stats, so like at level 80, that is. So you don't have to train them up to level 80. You can just Z-Awaken them from there. Alright, now we're going to go ahead and jump over onto the JP side of Dokkan Battle. So the first one is going to be Pan's Mysterious Adventure. It looks like it's going to be available forever. I don't know if it's available daily. It says it starts Tuesday at 1 a.m. I don't see it available now, so I'm assuming it's just going to be on Sundays. But it has another stage on it. That's why I figured I'd just bring it up here, because it did get an extra stage. So go ahead, utilize that. It's because that Pan Dokkan Awakens now, so go ahead, grind her out while you can. I think it's... should be available for you to grind out that stage, just so you can get the Dokkan Awakening of her. So when you see it available, go ahead, grind out the stage for that Awakening medals. Next is going to be the story reprint for the Broly, the same thing on the JP of the global set that we just talked about. 11:07. That is when this ends. So you have another week and a half. Week and a half to 2 weeks for this event. If you haven't already grinded out the medals, again, this is how you get the Dokkan Awakenings for the OG cards. JP side, if you haven't grinded this out already, that means you must have just started the account. But again, go ahead, grind it out. Same thing as global. Nothing else has really gotten added onto it. So same thing as JP as the global side. next one is going to be the Bardock event that runs until the 7th as well. So that is going to be available for another week and a half, 2 weeks as well. Again, grind it out. This is how you get the Awakening medals for the Great Apes. So Bardock will Dokkan Awaken into another Bardock, but he is better. He has each Great Ape has a double chance to go Great Ape now instead of just a single chance. Bardock's the Frieza medal. Fascia is going to be the Fascia medal, as you know, typical. And that's about it. So go ahead, grind them out. The cards aren't really worth it anymore. They're really, really outdated. But yeah, go ahead, have fun with that if you want to. Grind it out for the stones if you haven't already done so. Next one is going to be potential orbs available every single day until 10:22. So you have, that is actually expired. So never mind, ignore that. I clicked on that, I guess, by mistake. So this is the reprint for the Bojack and Gohan event are running until 10:31. This is for Dokkan Awakenings of Gohan to Super Saiyan Gohan, which is really outdated as well, but this is good for the base form LR Gohan. You could Dokkan Awaken into this guy, and then Z-Awaken him for a 50% chance to raise super attack of your LR Gohan. That is a grind. I did that for about a week and a half, 2 weeks. So that way when I pulled my LR Gohan, I could feed him in without using other Kais. It worked for me, but let me tell you how much of a freaking grind it actually was. It is so much of a pain in the butt. This is also where you get the Bojack medals to Dokkan Awaken your LR Bojack into big bad boy Bojack. And then you need these three medals to Dokkan Awaken your full power Bojack into LR Bojack. So that's what you're going to need for these. So that's a pain in the butt as well. I'm just so sick of grinding that. You also need the Gokua medals to Dokkan Awaken your Gokua into his full power form, I guess. So you can go ahead and do that. I believe he's an orb changer. And you get the Gohan medals to Dokkan Awaken your Super Saiyan 2 Gohan to, well, to him himself as Super Saiyan 2 doing the Kamehameha. The Bojack Gohan does a Dokkan Awaken anyway. The Agility and the Strength Bojack also both Dokkan Awaken. The Agility one Dokkan Awakens with singular Bojack medals into his other form. And the Strength one Dokkan Awakens, obviously, from the OG SR Bojack to his full power form. Then his full power form also re-Dokkan Awakens again. With another Bojack medal, so that's pretty awesome. And then you also have Zanya, who gets her Dokkan Awakening. So this event just holds so many goddamn Dokkan Awakenings, it's not even funny. They need to just stop with Bojack and focus on Korra. Like, that's what they need to do, because this is a pain in the ass. I'm tired of them focusing on the Bojack stuff. Korra event is so freaking outdated, They haven't done anything with it, and none of the characters are relevant. That event is only good for grinding out the Dragonstones, and once that's been done, it's just there to show up. They need to give us Korra's Armored Squadron or something like that, so that way we could actually have something to do. I'm sorry, I'm just angry about that. It's not like I'm a huge Korra fan either. It's just making the event useful for us. Anyway, story events are held at Dragon Ball Ultra Space. So that's the Tournament of Survival that runs until 1026. That's where you get the Goku, the Ultra Instinct Goku. Well, the base form of Dokkan Link is the Ultra Instinct. Urine, I only remember her name because of P. And Ultimate Gohans, which are farmable. And the Friezas, which Dokkan Link, and you can feed into the Golden Angel Frieza. Anyway, yeah, that's that event. Go ahead, grind that out while you can. That's a fun event. I still haven't done it on the JP side. Runs until tomorrow, so go ahead, grind it out while you can. I should do it for the Dragon Stones, because there's going to be a good banner coming up most likely soon. 1,000 Day Memorial Dokkan Fest, so that is the ticket banner gotcha. Runs until 11-3, so you have about another week before it goes away. I'll be doing a full summoning video with you. I'm grinding out every single day the Dokkan event so I can get those tickets, and we'll just do one massive summoning video. Probably take about 5-10 minutes, because there's not a lot of tickets that you're going to get. The Bojack summons run until 10:31. The physical summons run until tomorrow. So the monophysical with the double Elder Kai rate runs till tomorrow. Go ahead, grind that out. Nothing really worth here except for obviously the two support units, and that Trunks is a good support unit as well. Actually, that Pan's is good. You have four good support units here. So while I'm saying that, I'm lying to you. Those are really all good four support units. So plus double Elder Kai's, it's kind of worth it. But there's. I don't know if the LR Trunks is in that banner or not. Let us know in the comments below if LR Trunks is there. But that's a decent banner for use of double Elder Kai. And if you're going for a mono physical team, they really have some good units in there. And last but not least, the Dokkan Fest ends tomorrow for the Ultra Instinct Goku. So go ahead and summon for him if you like to. But anyway, guys, let me go ahead and post all this up on the screen. I put it all into a Word doc for you, so everything's there. It's actually funny because this is the first time that both sides had a whole bunch of events to go over, so that's why this turned into about a 20-minute video, or almost a 20-minute video. So, yeah, that's that, guys. Good luck on your grind. I hope that was very informative for you. Go ahead, pause the video so that way you can get all that information if you'd like to. And I hope you all have a great day. I'll catch you all tomorrow.